Welcome to Teddy Physics. So today we are going to solve with this question. So the resistors A and B consist of same material but different shapes and dimensions. What is the ratio of resistance of A divided by resistance of B of their resistances? So this is what they given, and they gave the wire. Here we got in a wire which is having resistance A. So this is A, means the wire has resistance R A, like that. And this wire, they gave the length of this wire is L, and the wire is in cylindrical shape. You know, right? Wire is in cylindrical shape. This is it. And they gave the B resistor is an cuboid. So length into breadth into height is the volume. So cuboid, a three-dimensional object. So this is what they gave, and what they are asking? They are asking the ratios of resistance R A and R B. So how much will be the ratio? This is what they are asking. So how we can approach this problem? Simple. So the solution for this problem will be carried by using a formula. Resistance R is equal to rho L by A. This is the formula we are going to use for finding R A by R B. So where R it means resistance, where R indicates resistance, L length, so how much length, and A means area. So this is the tricky part. Okay, the area, what area we are going to take, that will decide the answer of the problem. So now we are going to find individual resistances of A and B. This is what we are going to do now. So for resistance of A, comma RA, that is what we are going to find now. So how we are going to find it? So how it is look like? We'll draw this one. So this is it look like a cylindrical. So how a cylinder forms? A cylinder forms because of so many circles. So this is a circle, and here is another circle, here is another circle, here is another circle, like that. So many circles combine to form a cylinder. So how a cylinder forms means area of a circle multiplied by height. Area of a circle which is multiplied by height gives cylinder. Okay, so this is the area we need to consider. That is what I want you to stress it out. So this is the length of the wire, and area is this one. Okay, area of this circle which is multiplied by length. How much, how many times you are going to multiply that area gives the cylinder. So this is the area we need to consider. But the given diameter is D, capital D. So we can find out the radius. So we can find out the radius is equal to diameter divided by 2. So diameter they gave it as D. So diameter divided by 2 gives us radius. So what is the area of a circle now? Area of a circle, we know that area of circle is equal to, comma A is equal to pi r square. So what is this now? Pi r square means D by 2 whole square. It is nothing but pi d square by 4. So area we find out as pi d square by 4. As pi d square by 4. Now what we are going to do now? So here find the area. Now we are going to apply the formula, resistance formula. So resistance of A comma RA is equal to rho L by A. They gave that the two materials have two resistance have same material. So resistance A, resistors A and B consist of same material. That means resistivity is same. So no need to change anything there. So same is equal to rho L. Here what is the length? Capital L divided by area. Area is what? Pi d square by 4. Now send this 4 upside, then what we will get? Rho 4 capital L divided by pi d square. This is the resistance of A. We'll take it. We'll keep it safe. Then we are going to use it. Okay. So resistance of RA we found. In the same scenario, we are going to find resistance of RB also. So resistance of B. So resistance of B means what? So resistance of B, comma RB. This is what we are going to find now. So how it is look like? It is look like a cuboid. So cuboid indicates that so many squares is multiplied for a certain height gives a cuboid. So this is a square, same square plate, like that. So many square plates we need to arrange in this area like that. So how this length they given as 2L, and they gave that the side length. So the length of the side they gave, which is D. One length of one side they gave, it is D. But we know that area of a square, comma A is equal to how much? Length into length only. So square means length into length only. So they gave one length is D, that means length into length is nothing but D into D, which is gives us D square. So area of a square we got it. Now what we are going to use? We are going to use formula. So resistance of B nothing but RB is equal to rho L by A. So rho, same material, remember, so we are not going to change anything. L, they gave how much more? 2L here. So 2L divided by area is D square. So this is RB. Therefore, RB is equal to rho 2L divided by D square. Now in the question, what they asked in the question? So resistance RA and RB consist of same material but different shapes and dimensions. What is the ratio of RA slash RB? They are asking the resistance of RA by RB. So how we are going to do? Simply division only. So we'll do with a different pen. Therefore RA divided by RB is equal to, what is RA we got in previous sum? Rho 4L, sorry, previous page, not sum. Rho 4L by pi D square divided by, this is RB, rho 2L divided by D square. This is it. Rho will get cancels here. And after that, we will rearrange this equation 4L by pi D square into D square by 2L. So D square will get cancels here, and again this one also will get cancels here. L get cancels, 2 1s are 2 2s are. So how much we'll got here? 2 by pi. So 2 by pi, what is that? 2 by pi is nothing but what now? 2 by pi ohms. So no, this is a ratio. There won't be any units here because ohms divided by ohms gives what? Constant. There is nothing will be there. So it doesn't have any units. So now what is the answer for it? 2 by pi gives what is the answer now? That is equal to 2 divided by 3.14. 2 divided by 3.14, which gives as 0.636 is the answer here. Therefore, RA divided by RB is equal to 0.636. That is the answer here. Okay, thank you.